हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर तुषार गुजराती फ्रॉम SNDT कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग येवला। टुडे वी विल स्टडी सम सेंसर्स लाइक एनेमोमीटर, कलर सेंसर्स, EMG एंड ECG। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टडी हॉट वायर एनेमोमीटर। सो व्हाट इज हॉट वायर एनेमोमीटर? इट इज यूजफुल टू मेजर fluid flow and direction. So it is useful for measuring flow of the fluid and as well as direction of fluid flow. Okay, so tiny wire which is heated electrically above ambient temperature. So here in this case we are using a wire which we are heating electrically above ambient temperature. So what happens, this wire gets cools as air passes over it. As air passes over this wire, it gets cooled. So here the resistance of wire is directly proportional to liquid flow speed. Okay, so as wire cools or heats, what happens, the resistance of wire decreases or increases, and this resistance of wire is directly proportional to liquid flow speed. Okay, so in this case you can see that the diagram is shown. So left side diagram is constant temperature method and right side diagram is direction measurement. Okay, so in the left side diagram, gas flows from left side to right side through the pipe, and inside this pipe the hot wire is placed, and this hot wire is connected to one arm of the Wheatstone type bridge circuit. So as the flow speed changes, the resistance of wire changes, and it is measured with the help of galvanometer. So galvanometer gives us reading in the form of voltage. Okay, similarly on right hand side the diagram is shown. In the same diagram, what is shown over here, the same bridge circuit is shown, and one extra terminal is taken out for measurement of direction V. So depending upon change in direction, the voltage produced is either positive or negative, so that we get direction of flow. Okay, so like this hot wire anemometer is useful for measurement of fluid flow and direction. So application of anemometer is measurement of ammonia gas in chemical fertilizer factory. In chemical fertilizer factory, ammonia gas measured with the help of anemometer. Smoke and gas monitoring, so smoke and gas also monitored with the help of anemometer. Gas used in industrial furnaces can be measured. Okay, so now let's study color sensors. What are color sensors? So it detects reflected light from internal RGB LED illuminators. So we detect here light that is reflected from internal RGB LED illuminators, red, green and blue LED illuminators, and we compare it with high quality signal of real color. Okay, it uses halogen or tungsten light source. So it uses halogen or tungsten light as a source. It is used to identify wavelengths in near infrared, far infrared, ultraviolet range, 6 micron to 750 nanometers. So it is used to identify wavelengths in near infrared or far infrared, ultraviolet range. Okay, this is the wavelength that can be measured. Its application is fruit sorting based on color. So this is one of the application of color sensor. We can sort fruits based on colors. Textile thread identification, color verification, self illuminating items. So these are some applications of color sensors. So here the diagram is shown. So here light falls on red, blue, green and clear filters, and then it is given to photodiode array, and this photodiode array gives output to current to frequency converter, and then we get output square waveform. So this is the working of color sensor. So it consists of three colors, red, green and blue lights. One photo detector is there. So detect color shines each light to object. Okay. So this cycle is very fast, appear white to human eyes. So each light gets reflected or absorbed. Okay. So light detector sees whether the light bounces back.
Sensor will see nothing. The sensor takes note of whether
checks whether remaining colors reflect back.
Repeats the process with the remaining two colors. The combination of colors,
the readings determine color of the object. So this is the working of color detector.
A blue object, for instance,
blue object reflects blue, absorb red and green.
So if the sensor sees a blue reflection but no red or green, then it concludes that
sensor concludes blue and sends to EV3. Other possibilities, combinations.
And combinations are also possible. For example, yellow reflects both red and green.
If yellow object reflects red and green, absorb blue. So red plus green is equal to yellow. If no color reflects, sensor concludes there is no color.
Darker than even a black object.
If no reflection, then there is black. So like this, we have seen video of color sensor, so it is called as color sensor. Now we study biosensors. What is biosensors? It consists of biological material, for example, enzyme, antibodies, hormone, nucleic acid, entire cell. So these are all biological materials. This interacts with analyte and create physical, chemical or electrical signal. So there is some chemical reaction is present, okay? So these biological materials interact with analytes and creates electrical signal or chemical signal. Analyte is a substance whose concentration must be detected. So we are going to detect concentration of a substance which is called as analyte. For example, glucose, urea, pesticides, medicine. Okay. These sensors are used to analyze. Now here diagram is shown. So the biological materials are kept on this surface, optically or electronically active surface, and on that analyte is kept. Okay, so depending upon reaction between them, they generate electrical signal. So this electrical signal is received by this amplifier. Then it is given to processor and then we get display. Okay, so like this biosensor works. Also there is reaction between biological material and analyte, then bound analyte is formed, then biological response is formed, and then electronic response is formed, and then it is given to measurement. So like this step by step process occurs. So biosensors have some types. Electromechanical biosensors, they are used to bioelectrodes to monitor electrical current. So they uses bioelectrodes. Okay, bioelectrics are used to monitor electrical current. Amperometric biosensors are nothing but they are measurement of electric current as a result of enzyme catalyzed reactions is the basis for biosensor. So here enzyme catalyzed reactions occurs in case of amperometric biosensors. For example, Clark oxygen electrode measures O2. So these are some terms of chemistry. So Clark oxygen electrode measures O2. Blood glucose biosensors are available, used by diabetic patients for measurement of glucose, blood glucose. Potentiometric biosensors ion selective field effect transistors by sensors are used to monitor intramyocardial pH during open heart surgery. Okay. So biosensors are used to monitor intramyocardial pH during open heart surgery. So these are sensors which are useful in surgery. Okay. So EMG, this is one type, electromyography. Okay. So here the diagram is shown. So here in this diagram, the receptor is present. The receptor gives signal to cortex and spinal cord, and this electrical impulse produced is given to this myofibril. Okay, and according to this, action potential is given to this surface electrode, and it gives us muscle contraction. So like this EMG works. So to identify intents and physical state of patients, this EMG is used. Environmental variables affect its working. Used to analyze and record sequence of electrical impulses sent by body muscles. So for measurement of sequence of electrical impulses sent by body muscles, this EMG is used. ECG, electrocardiography. So it is used to record electrical impulses produced by the heart. So electrical impulses produced by heart can be measured with the help of this ECG. It is used to find physiological and psychological state of ones. So working principle is, when muscle contract, it creates tiny electrical current that can be detected. So tiny electrical current that can be detected when muscle contracts. It is done with electrodes placed on a body with special jelly. So one special jelly is used, which is placed on body. Okay. Current is amplified and recorded as a thin strip on a paper by electrocardiograph. So we can record that current with the help of electrocardiograph. Application, heart muscle check, cardiac disease, BP, location and degree of heart attack. So these are all applications of ECG. So like this, we have seen in ICU or anywhere in hospitals, ECG is plotted. So thank you so much all of you for watching this video.